Hi, my name is Andreas de Jong. How do we calculate the volume of a reservoir if all we know is its surface area or the elevation of the water level? In today's video, I'm going to show you how to do this in Excel. If you have any comments, please leave them in the comment section below the video. I hope you enjoy it. In the previous video, we worked on the Kajaki Reservoir in Afghanistan and I showed you how to calculate the storage and also the area of the reservoir at various water level elevations. We used the SRTM30 digital elevation model to do our calculations, and also we incorporated some historical data for data below the reservoir water level. Okay, so the first thing which we need to do is make a copy of our data, right click, move our copy, create a copy, and let's stick it right next to this data sheet, and we're gonna rename it and call it calcs. We're also going to have a quick look at our table name, and I'm just going to call it table data. Okay, we're ready to start. So we want the relationship between the elevation, I'm pressing on Control, and the storage capacity. Go to Insert, we're going to insert a chart, and the one we want is a scatter chart. Okay, let's be professional and add some titles to the chart. So the x-axis, we click on the x-axis title, go to the formula bar, click on it and press equals, and then we just click here on elevation, enter. And now our y-axis title, click on it, go to the formula bar, click on it, go equals, and that will be our storage capacity. Click on that, press enter. Of course, we need a chart title. The next thing we need to do is to add a trend line. Right click on the data, press add trend line. And the one we want is polynomial. Let's have a look at the formula by display equation on the chart and also the R squared, which is a measure of the accuracy. Right click on format, right click and then format trend line. And you'll see here, this is a second order polynomial, which means that y equals something x squared. If we increase the order to say third order, that's x cubed and so on. So basically you find the best possible fit. In this case, it is probably the sixth order polynomial, but that's not always the case. Be careful about this. So basically, this is our formula which we're going to use, but we need to increase the accuracy by format trend line label, and please select the scientific format. Decimal places should be 14, 1, 4, that's the magic number. If you use a higher number, it doesn't make it more accurate. You just get zeros after the last number here. Let's just try that out. If you put in 15, see, zeros start popping up everywhere. So 14 is our magic number. Okay, so we've made the first relationship between elevation and storage. Let's copy our chart and right click, move chart to a new sheet, and I'm going to call it. So now our elevation storage chart is ready. Let's make the one for area storage. So let's click on chart design, select data and edit it, and under the X values, instead of using the elevation, we're going to select the area. Press enter. And you can see that the chart has changed. Be careful, it still has the wrong label. Click on the label, select all this stuff, delete it, press equals, and click on the area label. Okay, so we have our elevation storage and our area storage curves here. Now, have a closer look at some of these data points. Now, they're quite close to our trend line, but the trend line is not absolutely perfect, which is what we're looking for. And one way that we can improve the accuracy is if we delete the data points which are not absolutely essential. So for example, down here, I think the dead storage is at 995 meters, so we're just going to get rid of these lower points, and there's no point really in going above 1,050, I think was the maximum that the reservoir could be flooded to if they add some more gates. Let's look at the air storage curve. You see the fit is much better, as is the elevation storage curve. So now we're going to extract the formulas. Let's make some space for them. First of all, we have okay, let's get the elevation storage formula. Click on the label here, select it, Control C, press Escape, and paste it. And now let's go for the area storage formula. Okay, so we have our formulas ready. Let's copy the elevation storage formula. We stick it in here, and we need to rename this. We have here our formula, and what we do is let's get rid of the Y at the front. So the first thing is an equal sign, so Excel knows it's a formula. So it says here this big number times by x to the power 6. So select the x, and we want to type in times, a little star. Click on the elevation, and now add a little hat, which makes it to the power of, and also select this edit, which we've done to the formula. So times elevation to the power of. I've selected it, Control C, go to the next X, I'm going to delete it, Control V to paste in my piece of formula, go to the next one, so backspace, Control V, the next one, backspace, Control V, the next one, backspace, Control V, and here's the final X, be very careful, Control V, but also delete the hat, so I'm doing one more backspace, and press Enter. Isn't that amazing? The storage here is 216, 216.9. Down here, 3070, 3065, so it's pretty close. So I'm just going to do the same thing for the area storage calculations. So I'm copying it, Control V, and I'm going to also paste in the title, get rid of the Y, replace the X by star, click on area, hat for power, select it all, be very careful that you select the right part, Control C, Control V, Control V, Control V, backspace, Control V, and the final X, backspace, Control V, backspace again to make sure you get rid of the little hat, press Enter. There we go. Okay, the numbers are looking good, but how good are they really? Let's calculate the errors. All we're going to do is go equals the calculated storage minus the actual storage divided by the actual storage. And for the area storage error equals, go inside the formula bar, storage calculated from the area minus the actual storage, click outside, divided by the actual storage, press Enter. So it all looks zero, but that's actually a bit misleading. Let's select all of them, go to home, and we want to use the percentage. And let's increase, sorry, this one here, one decimal place, and right align it. So here we see the percentage error in the calculated volume from the elevation, and that is a maximum error of just under 1%, and for the area, that's just under 2%, So we're pretty close. Our formulas are quite accurate within this range. Okay, that's very important. It only works over this range. Beyond it, above and below it, it will just give you rubbish data. Okay, so we're ready. Let's have a look what this means with some real water level elevation data. We're going to be using the satellite radar altimetry data from the Global Water Monitor, which goes back to 30th of December 1992 for the Kajaki Reservoir. So basically, we're going to stick our formula in here, and based on this elevation, it should calculate our storage. So we have to be very careful here. The title of this box is elevation in meters. So I'm just going to copy that and go to calcs. And we have here, it says arbitrary elevation. So let's replace that with the elevation in meters. If we do that, then you'll see that it has automatically updated our formula. So it just says elevation now. So we copy this formula, control C, escape. And we go to the water level, go in here, click on the formula bar, control V. And you should automatically see that this elevation is now blue and it's linked to the right box. Press enter. So what does it actually look like? Here's our chart of the estimated storage in the Kajaki Reservoir going back to 2008. In fact, it goes up to 1992, but I'm just showing this last few years, which is very interesting. Now, we also have the relationship with the area. So we're going to use a different data set for that. It is the Sentinel-2, which is a 10-meter pixel size satellite from the European Space Agency. And the NDVI was used to estimate the water area at different times, going back to May 2016. So here we have the area in square kilometers, and we're going to calculate the capacity. Be very careful. Area in square kilometers. Let's just copy this title. Go to calcs. And instead of estimated area, we're just going to replace that with area in square kilometers so that the formula is the correct one to use. Select it. Control C. Press escape. Click on here in the formula bar. Control V. You see it's all changed to blue and it selected the right one, and we have our calculated estimated capacity. Let's go to the chart, and you can see there's a really good relationship between the volumes calculated with the radar altimetry and the volumes calculated with the area from the Sentinel-2 satellite data. Now I've added a area correction box here, which we can use to see what happens if we increased our area by 5%. And you can see that the fit is no longer so good. We can also decrease it. Let's say if we decrease it by 5%, it also doesn't fit. So let's keep that at 100%. And if we go to the water level, if we shift our water level down by, let's say, a meter, you can see that it doesn't fit very well. If we shift it up by a meter, also not so good. So I think that both of our water levels from the Global Water Monitor and the area from the Sentinel-2 satellite data is quite useful to calculate, or let's say to estimate, the storage in the Kajaki Reservoir of Afghanistan. Today I've showed you how to calculate the storage capacity from water level and area. I hope you've enjoyed it. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below this video. Thank you very much for your attention.